as Bridgewater, New Hampshire. Population 36 has a huge buffet of single gay men.
Well, the all-you-can-eat buffet in Los Angeles has served me nothing but 7 heartbreaks, a mountain of therapy debt, and a chipped tooth.
The chipped tooth was your fault.
Hi, Nick.
Hey, I got you
a... Oh, so did I.
I wish I had a best friend like that.
You do.
You have me. I don't see you bringing me drinks. Bye, honey.
Well,
happy anniversary.
To 8 years.
8 years of coming to this party, but we've known each other for 9. Just took a year of social climbing to get the invite.
I think you did most of the climbing.
I did.
I think you should come home with me. We can pretend we fell in love after all these years.
Hold up, actually, that's good. Wait.
It would solve everything.
Uh-huh. I can temporarily bury the pain of my pathetic love life while also showing my family that I'm not a mental case who has no ability to be in a relationship.
By lying to them the whole time.
Yes! It'd be so easy. My family already asked why we're not just together.
Oh, all straight people ask that about gay friends.
Well, my early Christmas present for you is a blind date. His name is James. He's really cute. He's about your age. I really think you're gonna like him.
I can't believe Christmas Carol took down all your Britney posters.
I can't believe you ended our relationship without consulting me first.
Our relationship hadn't officially started, so...
Yes, it had. In our agreed-upon fictional backstory, it absolutely had. And then you went and endorsed the idea of me going on a blind date. As if we were looking for a third.
It's one date.
Exactly. It's one date. One date is not the same thing as a relationship.
Now, I don't have to lie to your family for 10 days straight.
You are the worst fake boyfriend.
Oh, my. Well. What a handsome new boyfriend.
No. No, this is my handsome roommate and oldest friend, Nick.
Hi.
Oh, hi. Uh-oh. My family already driving you that crazy?
Not at all. We're having a blast. We just ran out of wine midway through your nutty present wrapping thing.
For which wine is definitely required.
And you? Is the date that bad?
No. I just thought that if I showed up with wine for my mom, it would soften the blow of the real Christmas tree I'm also showing up with.
You got a Christmas tree on your date?
On the second half of the date.
On the second half of your date?
That sounds promising.
It's not promising.
It's not promising?
It's not promising. Shut up.
Well, if you didn't like him, you'd be telling me how much you didn't like him right now.
But we both know I like the wrong guys.
So you do like him.
I didn't have a bad time.
As your fake boyfriend, I'm not sure how I feel about you going out on dates with other people.
You asked for it.
Sounds like a solid, amazing date.
I thought I was gone all day.
Well, you were skiing. It's kind of an all-day thing.
Yeah, but it's already dark out.
It's dark because it's winter.
But I don't want it to be this one or the other thing for the rest of my life.
Well, it doesn't have to be, but you have to move back here.
That's what I'm saying. I think I do want to move back here.
Oh. So you really must like this guy if he's got you thinking about all of this.
Yeah, I don't know. It was 2 dates. He's just the straw that broke the camel's back. And when I think about it, what do I actually have in L.A.? A job I don't love, an overpriced apartment, an overpriced car. I mean, sure, there are people that I like in L.A., but you're the only person I love.
Well, I would really miss you.
Just feeling
a lot of things.
You'll be cold.
We can go inside.
I'm done.
Done with what?
Oh,
wow.
Thank you for this, for being so great with my family, for you.
Oh, that feels
turn, 1, 2, 3, turn. Oh, oh, smolder.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my God.
Come on, give me a big smile.
Okay, here.
Okay.
Stupid, I should
be. No, I like campaign. This,
here.
But you know what?
Oh, you just look so cute.
Yes, yes. I have an idea I want to do.
Like what?
Now I want you to look right into the camera, mm-hmm. and on three, breathe out so I can see the fog on your breath. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
You know, you talk about Nick a lot.
Oh, well, you know. It's my best friend.
Nick! Admit you're in love with Peter or we're not putting the ladder back.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Does it look like we're kidding you?
We've talked about this. Peter and I are just friends.
You guys are more.
And we think you know it, but you're not doing anything about it.
I know you care, but this is not the... Okay, wait! I do love Peter. You're right.
You mean you're in love with Peter?
Right. Yes. Can't believe I'm saying this out loud.
This may be weird to tell you, but my family has always had this thing where they think that Nick and I are supposed to be together. Which is weird because here I am on an actual date, a third date with you.
Well, maybe they're onto something. What if you and Nick have an undeniable connection that everybody can see but you?
Yeah, but don't you have one of those friends that everyone assumes is your boyfriend?
Hmm. No.
Oh.
So we want you to move back here with Nick.
Nick wouldn't want to move here. What would be here for him?
You.
And us.
Admit it. You have feelings for him.
Have I had feelings for Nick in the past? Yes. And maybe even now?
We talked to Uncle Peter. The feeling is mutual.